heads up if you clock a lot of OT at work. The Ford government's Bill 66 is about to become law. It changes the regulations around so-called overtime averaging. Right now, you must get paid time and a half if you work more than 44 hours per week. But overtime averaging, which was brought in under the Harris government, allows employers to average out overtime hours over several weeks, therefore avoiding some overtime pay. While overtime averaging isn't anything new, what this Ford government Bill 66 is going to do is remove the requirement for your boss to get approval for it from the Ministry of Labor. And while workers do still need to agree to overtime averaging, critics say this less oversight could result in some workers working OT but not getting paid for it.
What we've heard from employees and employers was that there was red tape there. There was an application that has to be made to the Ministry of Labor, and it was just stamped, and it was just a nuisance, actually, to all involved.
A nuisance for the employer, maybe not the employee, sir.
No, well, for both, actually.
While the government says approval for overtime averaging was just a rubber stamp, critics say it was important because it required employers to demonstrate a clear benefit to the employee.
So it takes out the step of rubber stamping. It gives the employee and the employer that flexibility to work together with the overtime averaging.
So if I report on City News and 680 News tonight that people in Ontario will have less overtime pay as a result of this bill, I would be incorrect in saying that. Yes or no?
Yes.
I would be incorrect.
Yes.
Nobody's going to get their overtime hours cut back.
No.
It's protection for the employer that allows them to make sure that, you know, to say to employees, you have to give me this flexibility, which I don't think is fair.
This is a way for employers to increase workload up to maybe even 60 hours a week in 1 week, and then decrease it down to like 20 hours the next week, and then average it and not pay overtime pay. That is not fair to workers. The Ford government is shortchanging workers, and it just tells you that they are not for the people.
Another controversial element of Bill 66 is that it takes away a rule that employers must display a poster informing employees of their rights. That's no longer going to be required. Inside the legislature, Richard Southern, City News.